Hello, my name is Marile Colon Robles. I'm the project scientist for NASA Globe Clouds, based at NASA Langley Research Center in Hampton, Virginia. It's a rainy day and I'm here with my girls. And we thought, why not share with you some of our favorite cloud activities to help you learn about cloud types. One of our favorite things is what we call the cloud dance. You girls ready to show the cloud dance? So before we begin, there's three main cloud types. There's many different types of clouds, but there's three main cloud types. Cumulus, very good, stratus, and cirrus. Okay, and we kind of drew a little bit of them. So cumulus are puffy. Kids sometimes say fluffy or cotton candy. Stratus are flat. Some kids say it looks like a mustache, right? And then cirrus, wavy, stretchy. We adults might say wispy, but kids don't really understand wispy. So they might say some words like that. So let's do a cloud dance. Are you guys ready? Ladies ready? Okay, so let's say cumulus. Now cumulus means pile. So let's pile. Let's make a cumulus cloud. Cumulus cloud. Oh my gosh, but the more we do it, the bigger it gets, the bigger it gets.
I saw it.
Okay, good. Because if you keep doing it, it'll be a thunderstorm. You don't want it to rain inside, right? Okay, now, let's do stratus. Show me stratus.
It's flat and it goes everywhere.
That's right, it's flat and it goes everywhere. So make sure to stretch in every direction. Now, Madison, do you want to do your mustache?
Mm-hmm.
Like this? Oh, I like that. Okay, now let's do cirrus. These are wispy and nice and fluffy.
And you can also do the dab.
Let's do the dab, because it kind of looks like the dab. Oh. Very good. Okay, now we're going to share with you some of the neat activities. Madison, can you sit down? Alyssa, can you come up? Now we looked, do you want to hold this up? We looked for some materials around the house and we did this. So I wrote the words. Cirrus clouds again are high clouds. Stratus and cumulus are low clouds. But if you notice, they're flat and puffy. So Elizabeth, what material did you use for here for the stratus cloud? I think this is tissue, right?
Tissue
paper. And what did we use for a cumulus? Yeah, cotton balls. And how about for cirrus?
String.
A string. Very good. And she wrote her name. Here you go. Can you sit down? Thank you for sharing. Madison, do you want to come? Now, Madison, come here next to Mama. What grade are you in?
Seventh grade.
She's in second grade. So we did a journal, right?
Mm-hmm.
So we found this strong material and made a hole, and then we laced rubber band. So what's in the front?
On the cover, it says cloud notebook. And if you want to, and we did this like per day, and if you want to make this at home, it's quite simple. First, you're gonna write the date, and then write the date of which the day is down on the line. Then you're gonna write the time now. Then you're going to write cloud types, a line across that, and the weather. And an example for the weather is basically like, so for us, the weather was very rainy and cold. So for the weather, we wrote rainy and cold. And usually during rainy and cold, it's usually nimbostratus, which is here on the board. And you write under in the line, you write sentence, and you write a sentence. And for us, for me, today, I wrote, today it is rainy and cold, and today it is rainy and cold and rainy.
Very good. So let's look at it again. This is how we chose to do our journal. So,
and you can do that per day.
That's right. So we're going to write the date, the time, the cloud type, the weather, and then because Madison is practicing her sentences, we're going to write a sentence about what we observed. Very good. Thank you. Can you sit down? Awesome. So this, the Clouds team just put out a family guide, which will help you do some activities with your kiddos or with the rest of the family, no matter the age. Now, there's other things that you can do, like there is a book about clouds through the GLOW program called Do You Know That Clouds Have Names? It's one of our favorite books. And then you can download it in different languages. So if you speak different languages like me, that yo hablo español y también hablo inglés, you can read it in different languages. Of course, you can make, you can use the Globe Observer app if you feel so inclined to make observations. And then within the app, within the Globe Observer app, you can find some cloud charts that can help you along figure out what cloud type are you looking at. So we're hoping that this will help you out, do some fun activities at home, especially if it's a rainy day like it is for us. So, Edison, you wanna come here? From our NASA family to you, we wanna say bye and have fun cloud observations. Say bye.
Bye.